I've made a copy of ODB 17 Intro to Queries, and I'm calling this ODB 19 Alias and Sort. After making the copy, I want to mention that I took the advice of Postman 1372 and reduced all my photos to be 300 pixels in height. I use paint.net to do this, but any photo editor will work. I clicked on Image, Resize. I clicked on the Maintain Aspect Ratio, and then I changed the height to be 300 pixels. Clicking OK. I reduced all my pictures this way and saved them to a file. Looking at our size, all of our pictures are between 10 and 16 kilobytes. And I was able to add all of my photos just as I did in video 15. I was able to load them all in at one time without any problems. Thanks, Postman 1372, for that suggestion. And we can see our pictures on our form at 300 pixels high. Looks just fine. There's no problems with this size picture. And our file size is still kept very low. Let's go back and do queries. And I'm going to click on Design View, also known as QBE. I like design mode, at least for these introductory examples, because it will prevent us from making typographical errors when we type in the table name. Let's add that in. Or when adding in our field names. Let's put in last name, first name, department, and group. So we don't have to worry about typing those names in wrong, and we also have a list here to work from, whereas when I opened it up in SQL View, we just had a blank screen and nothing really to work with. These row names on the side here, we've got something in field, table, and visible. These are checked, showing us that we want them all to show up in our result set. Table and field shows us exactly what table and field will show up in our result set. The table name is important because we could have the same field name on two different tables. The alias, what this will do, will allow us to change the name of the column in our result set. Right now, we've got last name. Let's change this to surname. I'm going to come over to department and type in DEPT, period. So we should see our alias names instead of the field names in our result set. I'm going to hit F5 and run the query. And we see surname did replace last name, but DEPT period did not replace department, and we have nothing down in this cell. That happened because although I typed it in, DEPT period, I didn't hit enter or tab or click off this box. I'm going to hit enter. Now it's locked in there. Now when I hit F5, we see that it replaced department with DEPT period. Let's see what the SQL code looks like for this. Clicking on Design View on off. We see it's not formatted. I will reformat this. Now we can see how to add an alias in SQL View. We need to follow the field we want to give the alias with as, and then our alias name in double quotes. Let's turn off our preview by hitting F4 and go back into Design View. The next thing we see down here is sort. Let's say we want to sort by department. We'll make this ascending. And then last name. We'll also make this ascending. I'm also being sure to hit tab or enter or click off that cell to make sure it gets locked in. Otherwise, we'll have the same problem we had with department and it won't be recognized. I'm going to run this. And it looks like it's sorted by last name, but not department. They're both they both made it in there. Let's go over to SQL View and see if we can tell what the problem is from there. Again, we have our single line. I'll reformat this. With this formatted, it's a lot easier to read, and we can see that we use order by in SQL View instead of sort. We can also see that it's sorting by surname before it sorts by department. That's why it looks like the department's not getting sorted at all, because we don't have any two people with the same surname. Let's swap these around. Now we're going to sort by department, then by surname. I'm going to hit F5. And we see we get our department and then alphabetically all our surnames. Let's see how this looks in Design View and see where we went wrong. So looking at our Design View, we have last name in here twice. The first time it's visible, the second time it's invisible, but we're sorting on this. So in Design View, it sorts left to right, and in this case, we want it to show up to the left of the department that we're already sorting. So we don't sort on this occurrence, but we add it in again to the right, and we make it invisible. Or we don't check the Visible tab. So in Design View, we go sorting left to right, and in SQL View, we use order by and go top to bottom. One last thing I'll mention in this video is if we want to rearrange our fields in Design View, we need to drag them left. I'm moving last name over and over. You can move it all the way to the end. But then to get this back over here, we can't just move it to the right. That doesn't seem to work. So I need to move the original last name, then the first name, then department, then group, and now we've got it back to where we had it. I'm going to save this query as ODB19 query sort. I'm going to save the database. And while we're in here, I'm going to change our other query name to be ODB17 query. And renaming this to ODB17 is just to make sure we know which tutorial we created that query in. And once again, I need to save the database.